लास्ट क्लास वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस जंक्शन बिटवीन मोटर नर्व मसल सेल दैट इज न्यूरो मस्कुलर जंक्शन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑलरेडी इन डिटेल. टुडे क्लास विल डिस्कस वंस आवर मसल सेल विल एक्सेप्ट स्टिमुलस हाउ आवर मसल सेल विल रिस्पॉन्ड फॉर कॉन्ट्रैक्शन. एंड यू ऑल नो कॉन्ट्रैक्शन इज यूनिक एबिलिटी ऑफ द मसल सेल दैट यू विल नॉट फाइंड एनीवेयर. Is it not? So let's see how our muscle cells used to respond after accepting stimulus from motor neuron. So see, this is what plasma membrane of the muscle cell, and you know plasma membrane of the muscle cell is also called sarcolemma, right? Sarcolemma means plasma membrane of the muscle cell have some receptors for neurotransmitter. Right, a neurotransmitter acetylcholine released from motor neuron. This neurotransmitter will bind with their receptors, and this binding of this neurotransmitter here will immediately cause opening of sodium ion channels. Right, the sodium ion channel will open. Right, and now this sodium ion channel will allow influx of lot of sodium ion. Initially, this muscle cell was at minus 90 millivolt charge. Now influx of sodium ion will increase charge here. It will get depolarized and charge will come to plus 70 millivolt. Okay. Now this stimulus will enter into deep of this muscle cell by the help of T-tubule. T-tubule means transverse tubule. And guys, when the stimulus will enter into the deep of this muscle cell, there are some specialized smooth endoplasmic reticulum that are called sarcoplasmic reticulum. What, student? Sarcoplasmic reticulum. Okay. This sarcoplasmic reticulum have lot of stored calcium ion. So when they will accept stimulus, lot of calcium ion will release. Calcium ion will release in sarcoplasm. In the cytoplasm of the muscle cell, lot of calcium ion will release. Right, and this calcium ion, you know, students, they will initiate the process of contraction. How? Let's see. Last class we discussed that actually there are two proteins, contractile protein, which involve in contraction. What are that contractile protein? Actin and myosin. Is it or not? So this calcium ion, you know, this calcium ion will bind with actin. Let's see the structure of actin, guys. This is what structure of actin, and this is what structure of myosin. So, I am writing here actin, and this is myosin. First, you will see actin structure. Actually, there are some globular protein, and this globular protein is called G-actin. G-actin protein. Many G-actin protein will organize, and they will form a structure that called F-actin. Many G actin will organize, and then they will form F actin, and now this two F actin will coil around each other, and then they will form actin filament. This is what our actin filament, actin protein. So actin protein have total two F actin, and in one F actin there are many G actin, which are globular proteins. Apart from this F-actin, you know, they have one more protein. This protein is fibrous protein and is extending in the whole length of the actin protein. Right? And this fibrous protein is called tropomyosin. Tropomyosin. Right? It's extending all over the actin. Apart from this tropomyosin, there is one more type of protein that is called troponin protein. Troponin protein. This troponin protein, you know, is three type here. First type of protein, troponin protein, is called troponin T. I am writing here. Troponin T. Okay. Next one is troponin C. And next one, troponin I. Troponin T is that troponin protein which is binded with tropomyosin. Troponin T binded with tropomyosin. Troponin C is that troponin protein that is going to bind with calcium ion, and the process of contraction will start here, right? And next one is troponin I, that I have discussed already in the last lecture, that this troponin I will mask the myosin binding site of actin. Okay, so once calcium ion will bind here with troponin C, right, so this troponin I will move away, it will unmask the active site, means myosin binding site of actin. Okay, so and then our myosin protein will bind there. So guys, this is what our actin protein have tropomyosin also, and it has three type of troponin protein: troponin T, troponin C, troponin I. Troponin T bind with tropomyosin protein, C will bind with calcium ion, I will mask the active site, means myosin binding site of our actin protein. This actin protein is also called thin filament. Why? Because it is thinnest filamentous protein and it is thinner than myosin protein. Now this is myosin protein. See, this myosin protein have two segments. This myosin is called meromyosin. And you see this one meromyosin, you see in this meromyosin, this size, this part of this myosin protein is bulky. This part is called head. Either you say head or you say heavy meromyosin. Heavy meromyosin, because it's bulky, right? Large in size, more molecular weight. That's why we are calling it heavy meromyosin. Okay. And then this part is called tail. Okay. Tail, you say, or you say light meromyosin. Okay. So I divided this myosin protein in heavy meromyosin is head and light meromyosin is tail. Okay. And this neck-like structure, you know, this head and this neck-like structure together called cross arm. When scientists studied this protein, you know, when scientists studied this myoprotein, they find it that in their globular head, there is one enzyme, that enzyme name is ATPase enzyme. Okay, this ATPase enzyme, you know, will break ATP into ADP and inorganic phosphate, and energy will be used for contraction. So ATPase enzyme present in the head region or tail region? Yeah, it's present in head region. Clear, student? Clear or not? And this ATPase is actually manganese dependent enzyme. Means for action of ATPase enzyme, of course it will break ATP into ADP and inorganic phosphate. Like this is ATP, they will break into ADP plus inorganic phosphate, but for this action magnesium ion is required. Clear? So I discuss actin and myosin. Now this actin and myosin protein, actually they are arranged in a structure that's called sarcomere. And this is what sarcomere, student, this is what sarcomere, one sarcomere is arranged, right? So in sarcomere, actin and myosin protein are arranged, right? And this sarcomere is unit for contraction, right? See the structure of sarcomere one. Now you see, this is one individual sarcomere, this is another individual sarcomere, and when they will accept stimulus, it will contract. You see, it have two type of protein. This blue color I drawn, you know, it's actin protein, right? And this red color protein is actually myosin protein. Actin and myosin present, you see. Now during contraction, actin will slide over myosin. Okay, and see this longitudinal line is called Z line actually. So this Z line actually is going to decide boundary of the sarcomere. So this is between these two Z line, whatever structure, this is what sarcomere. So between two Z line, my sarcomere actually, during contraction, actin will slide over myosin. Okay, and when actin will slide over myosin, you know, like you see, so this is myosin, they are myosin is like this. Okay, this is globular head of myosin. So during contraction, this myosin will pull, it will pull actin, or actin will slide over myosin, and they will come nearer. Though both sides, whatever myosin proteins are present, they will come nearer during contraction. And when they will come nearer, this actin is connected with Z line. Z line will also come nearer. And when Z line will come nearer, the size of sarcomere will decrease. And when size of sarcomere decreases, one cell has so many sarcomere, all sarcomere size will decrease. And when all sarcomere size will decrease, finally muscle cell size will also decrease. And when muscle cell size will also decrease, there will be contraction in muscle cell. It results contraction in muscle. And finally, contraction in muscle causes movement in muscle. Okay? So, these two proteins, actin and myosin, involves. Right? Now, exactly what is mechanism of contraction? Because once calcium, okay, calcium ion will bind with our troponin C and the process of contraction start, and I told actin will slide over myosin. How exactly happened? Let's see. Actually, no, the process of contraction is explained by a theory that's called sliding filament theory. And this sliding filament theory was given by two group of scientists. Right? In one group, the leader was Andrew Huxley. And next group, the leader was Hugh Huxley. Right? They given sliding filament theory and they explained it how actin slide over myosin. Let's see it. Sliding filament theory. So, see, this is what our myosin protein. See, guys, this is what our myosin protein. Okay? Myosin protein. Okay? And this is what our actin protein. Actin protein. For contraction, first myosin will bind on actin with actin. And after that, they will slide, actin will slide over myosin. So, in first phenomena, what happened here? ATP binded with the head of the myosin. And when ATP binded with the head of myosin, you know, head of the myosin have ATPase enzyme. This ATPase enzyme will break this ATP into ADP and inorganic phosphate. Okay? So, energy will release here. Now, this myosin is ready to binding. Here you see, in this step, myosin is ready to binding with actin. Right? And as ATP was hydrolyzed here, so this step is called hydrolysis. Hydrolysis. So, I am telling again, in this step, ATP, first ATP binded here, and after that in this step, ATP will hydrolyze into ADP and inorganic phosphate. And now, my myosin protein will be ready to bind with actin at myosin binding site. Okay? Right? And you see here they binded. After binding here, still our ADP and inorganic phosphate is attached at the head of myosin protein. After binding, our myosin protein will change posture like this. And you see here, it was here, now it's changed posture. Posture was changed, you see. It's changed posture. And now actin will slide over myosin, you see. Posture changed and myosin position is changed. Actin position is changed here, right? And after that, once our actin will be pulled, immediately ATP will come and bind here. And once ATP will come and bind here, myosin will dissociate or detached from actin. I am repeating this whole process again, friend. It's so simple. Myosin have to bind with actin and then they have to pull this myosin toward the center of the sarcomere. So see, how the process start, ATP will bind with our myosin, right? And after binding ATP, the ATP will be hydrolyzed. Energy will produce, and by using that energy only, our myosin will bind with the myosin binding site of actin. After binding, our myosin protein will change posture. It will move like this, and they will pull this actin toward the center. Both sides, they will pull like this toward the center of the sarcomere. Okay, and once this process done, immediately ATP and inorganic phosphate will release from the head of the myosin. okay, and once even this ADP and inorganic phosphate is released from the myosin, still our myosin is attached with actin. But once ATP will come and bind here, immediately our myosin protein will dissociate from the actin, right? So here only the process of contraction completed, and this cycle will repeat and begin. First step detachment, second hydrolysis, and next, oh, this step is called power stroke. This step is called power stroke. And see here, once this our myosin binded with the actin, this step is called cross bridge formation. So this is how actin slide over myosin and the process of contraction continue. Remaining things we will see in next class. Bye.